Hello, Airbus Cockpit Coach here. You're joining me inside Microsoft Flight Simulator 2024 using the Fenix A320. I'm going to be looking at how to perform the sidestep approach today. The sidestep approach can be required for a number of different reasons. Usually it's due to ATC, air traffic control, traffic flow requirements. Sometimes even on the ground in terms of maneuvering aircraft across the airfield, it may be better to have an aircraft land a little bit closer to its final destination on the ground. And sometimes, as pilots, we sometimes cheekily request a sidestep because it will be less of a taxi and therefore fuel saving for us. So we'd normally request that early on with the initial approach controller, and if that's possible, they'll coordinate between themselves, and sometimes we'll get a sidestep for that reason as well. Usually it's for traffic flow and to help out the situation. It can't always be performed. We must have good visual meteorological conditions, so we need to be visual with the runways as we are today. We're currently on the approach to Heathrow's runway 27 right, and we're going to be sidestepping over to 27 left. The key to this procedure is to brief it in advance, so if we have good weather we can anticipate a sidestep. Obviously if it's foggy, we're not going to be able to accept a sidestep approach, so we wouldn't brief that up, but certainly in today's conditions we would anticipate a sidestep and therefore would brief that approach. So we'd run through the approach plate and the missed approach procedure for 27 left as well as 27 right. In order to do this, we want to have the secondary flight plan set up. So we've currently got the information in here for 27 right, the ILS. I haven't put the bar in. Bar for this runway is 278. We want to use the secondary flight plan, so we'd copy the active and come down here to change the runway to 27 left. I don't need to put a star in. That's now into the secondary, and we want to cross check that. So all the information for 27 left is what we'd brief. Obviously the key things, you're likely to get a change in approach minima. You want to be looking at making sure you got the great same angle, usually the case in parallel runways. Any changes to MSA on the missed approach, and obviously looking at your missed approach procedure is key. And that's really the main reason why we'd throw this into the secondary flight plan. It's not so much for the landing part of it, because that can be done visually, and it's, you know, we're only going to set this approach in good conditions. It's more to have the missed approach information to hand. Obviously a last minute change is more likely to result in a missed approach and being unstabilized, and therefore we want to have the missed approach procedures in the system ready to go, so we can fly those off the flight directors if necessary. So it's really important to be briefed up. So we've got that now into the box in secondary. So what would happen is air traffic control will ask us if we can accept the sidestep. We'd either confirm or say we're unable. Today we're going to confirm that, and we're going to sidestep over. We disconnect the autopilot and manually fly onto the visual approach for 27 left. With the box set up and the secondary flight plan activated, you can then re-establish on the localizer using the autopilot if you want. We wouldn't normally do that, we'd normally fly down visually, but then use that information for the go around missed approach as we've discussed. So this one is all about being prepared, and it's really important to have the information set up so it's ready to go. If that's not the case, especially being single crewed, you're unlikely to get that set up in time, and therefore you'd have to decline the sidestep and most likely have to perform the missed approach and come back round. So we are fully visual. I'm going to take the simulator off pause. So we're establishing on the localizer there. ISO star lock. And air traffic control just asks if we can set the sidestep. And yes, we can accept the sidestep for 27 left. So we'll take the autopilot out. My control. Cat 1. A very slight turnover, so nothing too sharp, and then we'll come down to the secondary flight plan, activate the secondary, come into the performance, put in your new minima, which is 277 for this runway, 27 left. And visually manoeuvre over. Flaps full, speed checks, flaps full. Now you do need to check your airline standard operating procedures. Most airlines want you to be stable around 1,000 feet, at 1,000 feet. Some will allow for a late sidestep and therefore be stabilised by 500 feet. So do check your airline's SOPs with regards to this, they do vary. We are stable. Established inbound now, 27 left. The landing checklist, cabin is secured. Go around altitude 3000 sets. EKMMO landing, no blue. Landing checklist complete. So we're continuing to fly visually. It is quite common to get the sidestep approach in the real world, where you have aerodromes obviously with parallel runways. Continue. Float that. Reverse. Decel. We didn't get the spoiler deployment there. Some reason, but not to worry. We'll investigate why that was. They were armed. So that's the sidestep approach. Really important to be set up in advance, have it briefed, have it in the secondary flight plan ready to go if you think conditions are acceptable to allow it. It does seem to be a little bit more common on VATSIM, for example, especially at places like Heathrow, where inexperienced pilots are coming in, say, too fast, and they need to separate that traffic out. I often hear that sidestepping is, you know, happening quite a lot. So it's one to be aware of and be brief for. It's quite useful as well. I'd say sometimes it would help you out, especially in terms of taxiing time and so forth on the taxi. And do check your airline SOPs as well, as they do vary. Any questions on that, please drop them in the comments. And don't forget to like and subscribe to stay up to date with the latest content. Thanks for watching.